Hey everyone, Dennis Kay here. It is Saturday, August 28th, and I'm answering questions that I've received by email from different clients looking to do different things in Belize. And this is a really good question, so I thought I'd just go ahead and answer these questions via my YouTube channel, because many of you might be thinking of the same things when you're considering buying and investing properties in Belize. So let's just kind of go through it. I'll give you some information that you might find helpful. So of course, I'm going to keep this person's information as far as their name, location, confidential, but they are living in Canada. And they say they have a couple questions. So the first question here is, I don't really understand the first question. He says, is there an opportunity to invest in the financing of properties without owning? So I guess this would mean coming in and like offering money, offering hard money. You could do that. So for example, you could come in, offer someone hard money if they're looking for a loan, give them the money, and then you have a lien on the property. So you could probably do that. Most of the time, my clients choose to take ownership of the property and then sell it to them, and then ownership doesn't transfer until it's paid off in full. That's the more common way, but you could be a hard money lender in Belize and just offer money on a property. That's no problem. He asks, what is the process for taking back the land if the purchaser unfortunately cannot make payments? How difficult is that? I've created a very good video on this topic, and I covered that topic in really, really thorough detail. So I will put that video link in the description below. So that question's already been answered. But let me just go on to the next one. This is really interesting. He says, is there a process of buying a Belizean company that already owns the real estate and no transfer tax is paid? Second question, maybe purchasing a Canadian or US company that has title to the property. Do you set up different companies for each property if they are for investment? Not necessarily trying to skirt taxes, just want to understand the process. Absolutely. So these are really good questions to ask. So what you need to do is, first of all, imagine you're just doing a one-off. So you're just looking for that one deal. You just want to do one deal to sort of get it under your belt. So what we do is we get on a Zoom call together. We find out, look, how much are you looking to invest in this initial property? Are you doing a $35,000 to $55,000 investment? Are you doing $100,000 to $300,000? Or are you doing up to $1 million? And then with that information, we say, okay, what properties would give you the biggest bang for your buck? All right, where in the country of Belize, where on Ambergris Key can you find the good deals? What type of financing can you offer and why? And then we start to look for a property. Now, when we look for a property and find one, then is when we have to go in to do a little bit of investigation. We can answer questions about stamp tax and how much stamp tax would be, other things like that. So here's what we have. On the left-hand side of your screen, what we need to do is, first of all, consider how is that property currently titled? For example, is it in the name of the local Belizeans who own the property? All right, is it in their personal names? Or if the property is owned by foreigners, some of the United States or Europe or Canada, is the title in their personal names? In other words, Mr. and Mrs. Smith are actually on the title. Or is that property held in a Belize Chapter 250 corporation, which would make it locally owned, right? Or is it held by a foreign entity? For example, an Anguillan IBC or an IBC from Panama, BVI, et cetera. Is the property held in another type of entity, such as a US LLC or a Canadian corporation or some type of other entity? All right, so first of all, you find out, how is the property titled? And then you can ask the question, how should I take title to the property? So for example, if the property is owned by a Belize Chapter 250 corporation, and only that property is held by that corporation, so basically the purpose of that corporation is just to hold that property, then you have to ask the question, are the sellers willing to transfer the company? If they are, fantastic. You might as well take possession of it with at least Chapter 250. Or is it held in an Anguillan IBC? Now, a lot of the properties I deal with, the properties are held in individual IBCs. And when the property is transferred, that IBC comes with the property. It transfers as well. Is it held in US LLC, so forth and so on. Now, the typical stamp tax that is paid in Belize on all local to local transactions is 5%. 5% of the purchase price minus a $10,000, reduction off the total. So for example, if you're looking at buying a property that is $100,000, all right, that is the purchase price. The Belize government allows you to subtract $10,000 from that so that you have $90,000 and you pay 8% of that in stamp tax, all right, 8%, because we're going foreigner to foreigner, 8%, all right? So you're paying, the $90,000 purchase times 8%, and I'll clarify all this in a minute, you're paying $7,200 in stamp tax. So if the property is a local to local transfer, in other words, a local person to another local, or a Belize Chapter 250 to another Belize Chapter 250, typically the stamp tax is 5%. Most of the time, my clients are going to be paying 8% because most of my clients are foreigners. They're going to take title in the personal names or maybe an Anguillan IBC or some other entity. All right. So basically what I tell my clients is plan on paying 8% in stamp tax across the board. All right. Just make that in your budget. That's your numbers for your budget purposes. If by some legal means we are able to reduce the stamp tax, so in what areas could the stamp tax be reduced? An example, if the Anguillan IBC that owned property is transferring, many times that transfer of the company will come with a much lower stamp tax, all right? Not sure what that could be. It just depends on the deal, right? There's a lot of moving parts to that. Or for example, if you're buying multiple properties, all right? So let's say you're buying three or four properties all owned by one Belize Chapter 250. You could assume that company that could come with a little bit lower stamp tax. We don't know. We have to find out, you know, by looking at the details of how the company is structured, how many shares have been allotted, all that kind of good stuff. But at the end, you are going to end up owning that property in probably one of these ways right here. So you're probably going to own the property in either your personal names, Belizean Chapter 250, an Anguillan IBC, maybe a US LLC or other entity. And a lot depends too on where the funds are coming from. How are you investing the money? For example, is this your personal money or is this money coming from a self-directed IRA? Some of our investors invest with funds in their IRAs. And for that, we have to have a certain type of ownership structure to comply with the laws of the US and of Belize. So it looks like there's a lot of moving parts here. It's not really complicated, but to answer this client's question regarding, you know, these types of things like stamp tax and how to reduce it and everything, I would say, look, plan on paying 8% stamp tax. If for some reason in the deal, it allows for a little bit less, fine and good. Should you set up different companies for each property if they are for investment? Yes and no. For example, in my holding company, I own probably 10 to 15 different parcels in one company, right? But then I own another 5 to 6 parcels in another company, right? Why would I do that? I own some of my personal name. Just depends on the deal. When I got the properties, how much I got them for, what I'm planning on doing with them. Am I going to sit on them, keep them for myself? Am I going to flip them with financing? Am I going to build on them, operate some sort of business? So I just kind of take a look at each deal. And this is where, you know, kind of a good Zoom call can go a long way in helping to iron some of these things out. This is it. It's not complicated, but there are some nuances. And once you start to move forward, Alberto and his team at Belize Investments is a really good source of information on this, all right? Because they can help assist in forming the companies, keeping them up to date, renewing them each year, advising you on which type of company might work best for you, you know, depending on what you're planning on doing with it. Are you going to own it solely yourself, or is there a mate involved, or are there children involved? All sorts of things like that that you want to sort of, discuss before you end up deciding which one of these is right for you. All right, so I hope this is helpful. If you have any comments, questions, concerns, let me know. And I'll be happy to go through some of this information in more detail with you over a Zoom call. If you want to jump on a Zoom call with me, it's really easy. The link below to buy Steph and I a couple cups of coffee. We really appreciate that support. And that allows us to open up a window of time during our week to jump on a call with you and spend some time unrushed, find out how we can help, and we'll go from there. All right, thanks a lot, guys. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you soon.